In this video, I want to talk about incorporating some interesting styles of charts into your FileMaker solution. Now, these styles of charts are not part of FileMaker's standard charting engine that's built into the FileMaker platform. Now, of course, we could expand our available gallery of charts by purchasing a plugin and installing it on FileMaker Pro, or installing it on our FileMaker server and then potentially accessing that with some scripts. But I want to show you an open source free online tool that you can use to access some additional types of charts. Now, this is made available by Google. Google, of course, seems to have its finger into everything these days, and Google Charts has been out for a while. Now, Google has a million different types of charts that are already created and built. In fact, their gallery is infinitely larger than what FileMaker has in its built-in gallery. In fact, what's interesting about Google's charts is that some of their charts are actually interactive and or animated, which is really cool. So what I want to do is show you how you can kind of hijack or hack a Google chart and incorporate it into your own FileMaker solution. Now, first off, to do this, you're going to want to go to the Google Charts website and find a chart that you actually want to utilize. Now, to keep things interesting, I'm going to focus on a type of chart that's not available within FileMaker's current charting engine. Here's a gauge chart that Google has set up, and I've actually used this in some of our internal databases, and if you purchased or watched any of our training, you may have seen this chart being used. Well, that chart comes from Google, and every time the chart renders in FileMaker, FileMaker actually sends a request out of FileMaker out across the internet with some data, and Google actually renders the image and sends it back to our web viewer in FileMaker, and FileMaker displays that for us. It's pretty slick. Now, of course, if suddenly the internet goes down, or if Google goes down for some reason, then that chart won't render. Of course, if the internet goes down, then the access to my shared FileMaker database probably will be lost as well. I've been using this gas gauge kind of chart for probably 6 months now, and I've only noticed it one time where it was not available or it was offline for some reason. And that's where FileMaker was working, my internet was working, but Google for some reason wasn't available, or something was wrong with maybe the Google server. And of course, after 4 or 5 minutes, I did a refresh and suddenly it all came back to life. So who knows? So how do we do this? Well, you're gonna go to this website, and what's going to happen is that you can see the sample and you can actually grab the HTML for yourself. So what you're going to do is copy the entire block of HTML. And instead of me trying to explain to you how all the bits of the HTML work, we're just going to kind of quickly hack this together and throw it into FileMaker. Now, if you just take this and stick it into FileMaker by itself, it's not going to work immediately because we have all these quotes in here, and FileMaker has to have these quotes all properly dealt with when you put it within a calculation. So what I do is I fire up an application called Text Wrangler. Text Wrangler on the Mac is a free app, but if you're on Windows, you can find something similar. And what I do is I just paste the HTML in, and then what I do is I do a find for every quote, and I simply replace it with a backslash quote, which means I'm essentially escaping the quote. I'm making that quote palatable to FileMaker, because FileMaker won't like just plain quotes by themselves. So Text Wrangler reports that 16 changes have been made, and they're all in here now. Notice that every time there was a quote, it's now been escaped. Pretty slick. So I copy this. I can move it out of the way. I can go into FileMaker, and I can start a new database. Call it Test2. And what I'm going to do to get this going initially is just draw a web viewer on screen. Now, to make all this work, I'm just going to put this HTML in here like this. But in order for this to work, you actually have to make this what they call a data URL. So FileMaker knows how to handle this properly. Because if I don't actually notate that this thing is actually a data URL, then FileMaker is going to freak out. It won't actually operate correctly. You notice right here that Nothing actually happened. So I go back to layout mode. I go in here. I'm going to hit specify. And I'm actually going to tell FileMaker that this is a data URL. So the data is actually self-contained here within this calculation. So we have this leading element right here, and that's super, super, super important. I say OK. I say OK. And I go back to browse mode. And bingo, we actually have the functional gas gauges from the website running in FileMaker. Of course, now you think to yourself, well, now we got to make this actually useful to us. So the next thing we need to do is go in here and start modifying this. Now, the one thing that's interesting to notice about this is that there is this animation that goes on in the system. And that's this interval right here where it was playing with the numbers automatically, so it would cause the gas gauges to somewhat automate themselves. So what we're going to do is I'm actually going to remove this section in here carefully. And what would be good is to actually save this into a text file or maybe a notepad off screen. That way, if it doesn't work, I can always come back to it and figure out what I did wrong. And I hit OK. And so notice the code now is a lot smaller. I go to browse mode. So now we have memory, CPU, network, and we have these numbers here. Notice the numbers aren't animating. So now we're getting down to the fact that we actually have three gas gauges, and they're not animating, and so we're beginning to get our head wrapped around the concept that we can actually start to control what we're doing here. And so now what we have is we actually have the area that actually controls the three gas gauges, and that is right here. Right here are the areas that control the three gas gauges. If we want 2, 3, or 4, it's all controlled right here. So what we can do is we can actually change these and maybe add a fourth one. We could say marketing. Maybe this is their, you know, score at a team event. This is maybe engineering. And I don't know if these will actually fit in the gas gauge. And sales. And HR. Now down below here, we actually have the ability to actually set the colors, right? Yellow from here to here, red from here to here. I'm not entirely clear on all the colors that are approved for use with this specific chart. You'd have to go back and look at the chart documentation. But I know that the basic colors have been used and I have used them. So I'm just going to change red to green, for example, just for fun. And I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to hit Browse. And I'm going to watch my chart not work. And why didn't it work? Because that's how sensitive things are. There's one missing comma right there between these two charts. I added a chart, and there's a missing comma right there. One whole missing comma. One missing comma, and the chart quits working. And there you go. Notice the color green took over from red. Notice the spelling of the words came out about right. Now, I actually had this dummied up in another sample file. What's interesting to notice here, these gas gauges here are actually a little bit bigger than these four down here. I wonder what's regulating the size of those gas gauges. Because I don't see an actual gas gauge size anywhere in here. I wonder if I get rid of one of the gas gauges, if that will make it happier. Yeah, and so there's obviously some automatic logic here that you can look at. You could probably specify within the documentation the size of the gauges you want. You have to go back to the documentation that you saw to see if you can specify the size and add that as a parameter. But as you can see, it's not that hard to actually grab these things and actually customize them. Of course, once you have this information here, you can actually substitute in variables here or substitute in values for fields in here. It's actually all quite simple. Pretty straightforward at this point. I can show you briefly what we did for the gas gauge. For FM starting point, we use it to keep track of the downloads on a per day basis. So I've jumped into a copy of FM starting point that we use for managing our finished goods. I can press this button right here, which will update these numbers right here. Now I'm connected over a wide area network from the FileMaker server. It'll take it just a second to update these numbers. Now, these numbers don't update every time I come to the screen, because that would be a real hassle. If every time I navigated to the screen, you saw these calculations fire off. So this only updates when I ask for it to update. Now notice the downloads for Friday are 96, the downloads for Saturday are 64, and so the weekend downloads for Starting Point are actually quieter. But over most normal weekdays, we have 100 plus downloads of Starting Point. So how does this calculation look? Well, if I go to layout mode, and I double click here, and I hit specify, you can see that we've actually substituted in actual fields in here and values. And so just like I said before, it's almost identical to the sample we just saw. So to hack this together and put it in your own database is a snap. Really straightforward. All you have to do is substitute in the fields or variables that you want to use. Now these fields are just number fields and text fields. They don't update automatically. That's back to the whole conversation about not using unstored calculations on screen that dig deep into a database that's being accessed across a wide area network. If you do that, you may sit and wait. Most of the time I flip to the screen, I'm navigating from contacts to accounts to invoices, and I don't need the latest information from the chart. But if I want to know how my downloads have gone, it's end of the day or the beginning of the next day, and I want to get the latest information, I press the update, I wait 15, 20 seconds, and I get that information. And that information then is cached and saved until that update is run again. So this is really, really cool stuff. Really simple to implement, and it adds a whole level of additional capability, and frankly, levels of awesomeness to the FileMaker product line. So if you have any questions about the gas gauge charting or Google Charts in general, feel free to email us at support@rcconsulting.com or reach out to the FileMaker community as a whole. There's a number of FileMaker forums out there where people discuss these kinds of topics, and they'd be happy to answer your questions about this and other things. Because this isn't the only way to chart. It's just another tool to put in your toolbox to save. So when someone comes to you and says, hey, can we chart a certain way? You go, aha, I've saw that before. I know how to do that. Let me show you how. So for Richard Carlton at learningfilemaker.com, I'll see you next week.